The Insight Project is a rare example of artists, scientists, and mental health experts coming together to tackle one of the most pressing challenges of our time, mental suffering.
We're asking a question. Could we combine the best of game design and technology with cutting-edge clinical neuroscience and psychiatry to help with mental suffering and to promote mental well-being?
The Insight Project is Ninja Theory's bold ambition to use technology, game design, and clinical neuroscience to develop new therapies for mental disorders. I'm excited and proud for Ninja Theory to take their passion to the next level with the Insight Project.
My name is Tamim Antoniadis. I'm the Chief Creative Ninja and co-founder at Ninja Theory, a Cambridge-based games company. For the last game I directed, Hellblade: Senua's Sacrifice, my principal collaborator wasn't an artist, but a scientist. And he opened my eyes to a whole new reality.
My name is Paul Fletcher. I'm the Bernard Wolf Professor of Health Neuroscience at the University of Cambridge. I'm also medically qualified, practicing as a psychiatrist, and I've been interested in studying and helping to treat mental illness for a long time. I was approached by the Ninja Theory team some time ago when they were asking for advice on representing mental illness within a video game.
In this waking nightmare,
I had a friend who had suffered a mental breakdown, and I realized that I knew nothing about the subject. And the more I read about it, the more I just wanted to know, what does it feel like? So that question turned into an idea, a concept. What if we could step into the shoes of someone who has severe psychotic mental illness and see, hear, and understand the world through their eyes?
By engaging with the science through Wellcome Trust and the University of Cambridge, and by collaborating and co-producing with people whose lives had been blighted by mental illness and suffering, the Ninja Theory team produced a really remarkable depiction and genuinely conveyed a sense of the experience and the impact of psychosis.
Players with mental health difficulties in particular responded with praise. Many saw it as a tool for expressing their suffering to their loved ones.
Ninja Theory showed the value of these collaborations, bringing a level of authenticity and empathy to a challenging subject. And we're really looking forward to finding how we can work with them again.
Paul and I were variously invited to talk about our work at the Houses of Parliament, Kensington Palace, and several science conferences. And it was at these events that people often approached us afterwards, saying that we must keep going and build on what has been achieved.
We kept returning to this profound insight that what Hellblade had achieved was to make the invisible visible. What if we could go further and give people the ability to see, engage with, and perhaps even overcome their fears and anxieties? This became the Insight Project.
I really hope that this project really helps us to understand how to deal with anxiety, how we can measure, understand, take control as human beings, not just over our mental and physical health, but over the digital world more generally.
But why do we think games could help? Well, over the last decade, the games industry has been in an arms race, developing real-time technologies such as virtual avatars, natural human-computer interfaces, data analytic tools, online technologies that are at levels of sophistication that are grossly underestimated by the wider world. And all of these tools were created to engage a captive mass audience, train them in new skills, and promote mastery of games. And this is a tool set that we think could equally be applied to mental well-being.
We recognize that there's a powerful and widespread movement in science and psychiatry based on acknowledging that the brain and the body are truly intimately related and must be considered as a functioning unit. But game technology gives us a missing piece. It gives us control of the person's environment. This is enormously powerful.
In-house, we are creating some of the most advanced interactive characters and realistic environments ever seen. And we're going to use the best of our skills and technology to create a compelling and rich experience that appeals to anyone and everyone.
We're currently in the early stages of prototyping, testing how one can interpret and use biometric data to create and control simulations linked to mind and body. Alongside this, we propose to conduct formal experiments to verify the results systematically and to make them widely available through established scientific channels. This seems to me to be a new kind of clinical science. It's one that recognizes the need to throw off certain constraints of the laboratory and to harness the creative skills of game makers.
The beauty of cross-sector collaborations is that they almost always stimulate fresh thinking and unexpected ideas, often with benefits to both sides.
And the BAFTA for Artistic Achievement goes to...
I just think it's an awesome kind of team and collaboration. And I am just so happy that they've really been serious about continuing with that journey.
My hope is that the team at Ninja Theory uses the Insight Project to attract other pioneers in the mental health field, and that they collaborate on new approaches to developing treatments for mental disorder. The Insight Project is a great example of the power of games to be a force for good.
Over the next few months and years, we will be sharing our approach, publishing our findings, and growing our team. The project will grow in complexity as we tackle harder and harder problems for which solutions may not yet exist. However, we do believe that by focusing our efforts on what we can do now and collaborating with those who can offer different or complementary solutions, we can kickstart a movement. One based on sound principles and help each other to find ways of improving the quality of life for a lot of people.